well come in and rest your souls and have some tea. Do you have something there?
Fat ass fat bitch big tits is gonna get hot. She ain't got the dignity for these streets.
We come back, I'm gonna get freaky. Why don't you go out of your mind or something? I'll be back. Soul music for lovers.
Fever 105.
Fever 105.
Not Vietnam, even though they do have a lot in common. I noticed there was one thing missing from this great town, a celebrity-endorsed used car shop. That's why I founded BJ's Used Autos. Every one of these beauties is freshly painted. They look brand new. We have new models coming in every morning, usually around 2 a.m. We can get you anything. And if you see a car in your dreams, tell us. We can acquire it for you. I've taken the skills I've learned as a pro football player to the used car business. Smash, grab, and run like hell. BJ's Used Autos. I'm tackling low prices with hot cars.
Maxing and relaxing, baby.
Fever 105.
that awful?
Next guest is from the opposite end of the political spectrum. A man so wet, he looks like he just stepped out of the shower. Peace Corps activist, hippie concert taper, founder of the group Speaking for the Underdog. He is fluent in 7 languages and studied the harp in Peru, Callum Grayshaw.
Hi, Maurice.
Hola.
Buenos dias and noches. Bonjour and buongiorno. Welcome in. Hello. Hello. Hi.
Hey, let's stick to English. Most of us struggle enough with that. Welcome to Pressing Issues. And lastly, we have a man with a novel solution to the problems of public safety in bicycling. A solution so stupid, I cannot bring myself to explain it for him. Yet like breakdancing, it is sadly catching on. A man who appears on this fine show because our previous know-it-all panelist was carjacked and is now at home arming himself to the teeth. I give you John F. Hickory.
How y'all doing?
Indeed. So, before we get started, gentlemen, let me remind you of the rules of engagement. Here on Pressing Issues, the number one rated show on public radio in the Bay City area and hosted by me, Maurice Chavez, Pressing Issues is about free speech, not feeding each other hemlock, literally or metaphorically.
Hey, my daddy used to grow that stuff in the backwoods of Missouri.
Hey,
I tell you what.
Yes, thank you. I expect you to listen to each other, and I will only step in where necessary so people on the air don't forget what my voice sounds like. So, I want a clean fight. Nothing below the belt or in the chops. And remember Maurice's motto, which a very wise man, my father, once told me. If you listen, one day you might be hurt, and when in doubt, use the smell test. That's so important, I think, don't you? So, Congressman, let's start with you. Crime is up. People are scared to walk the streets. Nobody is taking public transportation. Police morale is at an all-time low. Everyone is killing and maiming and giving each other the finger, metaphorically speaking. Do you think the government is doing a good job?
Absolutely. Those statistics are interesting, but like all statistics, they are also irrelevant. Let me give you a better statistic, Chavez. In 1980, when I was elected, you were, according to the intelligence gathered on you, a man with no mission. You worked as a clown at birthday parties, corporate functions, bar mitzvahs, and go-go bars. You, realizing that you were a hollow man that can only take on the personality of others, decided to become an actor. And despite going up for 17 auditions that year, you only got work as a fluffer in a sex ed video. Your tax returns show that you earn less than $2,000. Suffering from anxiety, you attended group therapy for a year and considered getting a sex change. An idiot liberal felt sorry for you, and now you host your own radio show, write a newspaper column, the Blind My Birdcage. You've got an ex-wife and attractive girlfriend, although she's married to your best friend, and you're on top of the world. So answer me this. Can you really say the years of living under my administration have been bad for you?
We are not talking about me. This is Pressing Issues, not Pressing Maurice.
Yes, excuse me, if I may, can we get to the part where we press the issue?
You see, that's what's wrong with this city. Liberals just want to open the floodgates, let anyone in, and make you, the ordinary, hard-working men and women, pay for the pleasure. Well, you have my permission to beat them with sticks. We won't prosecute. You'd be doing us all a favor. Free love, wig out, don't work, make love in the field, and listen to rock and roll or whatever you call it. Meanwhile, Grayshaw, I know your father. He's made a lot of money, which makes him a great person, but for every good conservative, they end up having some wacko commie kid just back from a vacation in the Orient who wants to share. Go take that share in business to Cuba, Canada, or somewhere. I don't have a trust fund or a rich daddy. I know what it is to be poor, to look at the world from the other side. I slept my way to the top.
If you two would stop hooting and carrying on, I have a plan that will save Florida from the yellow-bellied snakes that want to slither into this great state from all places north.
Oh, look. Stump-jumping Jethro is using all three of his brain cells to talk.
Enough! We've just started and you have proved yourself, Mr. Shrub, to be just as they said. I grant you, 1980 was not a high point in my career, but I never applied for a sex change. I was merely in an exploratory phase, and besides which, Saul the Wheat-Free Clown was a funny act. Once voted best up-and-coming dietary-restricted comic act in the whole of Vice City. I tried to take it to the Catskills, but Mount Scary Large was full. Besides, we are not talking about me. We are talking about you.
Actually, if I remember correctly, you didn't win. Mary, the meat-free mime, won. In fact, under legislation I am proposing, all of you vegetarians would be kicked out of Vice City. We were given canines and bicuspids for a reason. To open packages of potato chips.
Hey, don't get me wrong. I always hated that bitch. What's funny about a woman not eating a hamburger? Or miming saving a chicken from the slaughterer's hands? Or her big act, I am a milk cow, a lactating machine for your breakfast cereal. How do you think a little kitty enjoyed that on his back? Not very much. There were tears, not laughter. I can assure you, vegetarian performance art must be stopped.
Jumping Jehoshaphat on a pogo stick. You city slickers got more issues than a newsstand. Can we talk about public safety here? I ain't got all day.
What? Is there a corn on the cob eating contest you have to get to? Get some chitlins and grits in the oven? You got a date with your sister, eh?
Hey, be nice, man. I just wanted to talk a little politics and you made it all... people only. That's what I say. I mean, I don't go to Alabama to visit a theme park, so why do they come here?
Mr. Hickory, your views are a little extreme. Plus, I don't believe there are theme parks in Alabama.
Then they should stop coming down my way and build redneck land or whatever. Damn, redneck hicks ain't got no class. My views ain't extreme, mister. They're common sense. And what a lot of people would say if they have the guts. If you keep letting people immigrate here from all over the so-called United States, guess what? There's no more room. We'll be piled on top of each other like they are in Australia. What we're gonna do soon is build a river. A river of freedom. A river of hope. A river which runs from the coast to coast and cuts us off from the 47 states of wastrels and bad influencers to the north. We are going to cut Florida off from the mainland of our oppressors and float out to sea. Then, the nation of Florida will be free to start over. There'll be no long-ass lines at the log flume or the pirate ship ride when I take over. You and the kids will be able to ride the rides all day. We will have a roller coaster for each and every Florida family.
You know, you're bordering on treason. What you are saying is a very naughty thing, and only because here on pressing issues do we believe so wholeheartedly in free speech are we allowing it.
It's the truth, my friend, the damn truth. And before you start, I am not a racist. I hate everybody irrelevant of other issues. But I especially hate Yankees, by which I mean anyone from Georgia or further north. Build your own theme parks, buy your own sun, grow your own damn mosquito-infested swamp. We'll build ourselves a river. FBI, CIA, I don't give a damn. They can't stop us. You shrub, you yellow-bellied, tie-wearing, bribe-taking hypocrite. What have you done for Vice City up there in Washington?
I've ensured important tax breaks for gun retailers, real estate developers, and I've cut the cost of policing, saving the city 2% or 25 cents per household over a six-year period.
At the expense of society. Think of the little people. Poor people have no voice in this city. Every time I find a park to meditate in, someone brings in a bulldozer and builds condos. The madness must stop.
So you suggest we just stop making babies? People need a place to park their boat and trailer and put their swimming pool. You're beginning to sound red, and by that I mean you prefer a hammer and sickle over a hamburger.
I'm not little. I'm 5'5". It's time for corporations and all of capitalism to step aside for naturalism. You're not saving this planet. You're spending it. Your credit is no good here. We can't afford to loan you any more of our nature. Those are our trees. I only wish I could be around a little longer to enjoy it. I feel so old. Someone must take my legacy. I must train a little me.
How old are you?
I'm 23, but I feel much older and wiser. I know everything. I've seen a lot of...
The rest of the world have to tell us about how to do things. Build more trains, have people elect their leader rather than an elite electoral college, ride a bike to work like a Girl Scout, or a clown with dietary concerns. No thanks, Vladimir.
I'll agree with that. People from other countries are good for nothing. That's why we have to keep teaching them a lesson. I tell you what makes a real man. A truck to pull stuff and a couch to think on.
I'll tell you. Speaking as a sensualist, and by that I mean a very narrow-minded, id-centered man of peace, and travel. I recently went to Europe. I think everyone should see it for a week. You really see what's wrong with this country when you visit a European utopia. Things like a germ, public transportation, healthcare, leather shorts, mustaches. When I went to Belize, I helped some villagers clear some land for an environmentally friendly coal mine. We've all got to make some sacrifices if we're going to get anywhere. My dad gave me the money to set up an exciting trust there.
But how does that help the people in Vice City from worrying about whether they're gonna get robbed?
What drives a man to just take? What we need are more after-school sports, like choir or drama, so people can learn to express themselves properly by singing or pretending to be a tree. Have you ever heard a whale sing? It's a lonely form of beauty and some very ancient wisdom. Helping people to help themselves with drama and choir and flowers and my dad's money.
To reduce taxes to zero.